People keep asking me, what's the best system monitoring application for Apple macOS systems? So in this video, I will show you how to install, configure and use the best tool for complex advanced Mac system monitoring you can get. So stay tuned. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud and I help people with their Apple Macintosh computers and Hackintosh builds. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. Most complex and advanced system monitoring tool for macOS is called iStat Menus. I used this tool since macOS 10.5 Leopard, so really a lot of years. Each version is getting better and better, but the principle is still the same. In real time, you have absolute overview of everything what is going on your Macintosh. Or Hackintosh. It's sitting in the top menu bar, so you don't even need to click anywhere, and you still have all informations in front of your eyes all the time. Real-time info about CPU usage and history, most demanding processes, info about memory and processor utilization of your GPUs, temperature, clock speeds, utilization history of each CPU core separately, memory pressure, used free values, applications with biggest memory usage, again up to 30 days history graph, swap memory info, real-time details about your network connections, read-write speeds, again also with graphs, utilizations of all connected disks and server shares, real-time read-write graphs and overview which application is using and how your disks, temperature, voltage and wattage sensors of your CPU on per core basis, motherboard temperature and voltages and so on. Simply insanely detailed informations of your whole system and all is presented in very nice sleek design. I will show you right now how to install iStat Menus monitoring tool on your Macintosh or Hackintosh and how to configure it. Navigate to this webpage, link you can find in this video description. Scroll down and click on the download button. Once downloaded, open the zip file and drag the iStat Menus application to your Applications folder. Now you can start the app for the first time. Click on the Install Additional Components. And done. Installed. At default, it will not look like this because iStat Menus remember my settings from my previous installation even after uninstalling for the purpose of this video. So I recommend to start with a fresh canvas, so disable all groups. Keep in mind the order in which you will activate these components, in the same order they will appear in the top menu bar. So when I first activate the CPU, it will always be at the first place. You can highly customize the look of each component simply just by dragging these available items. I like to have the name there, I want to have the CPU history graph, and also each core activity and even overall CPU usage percentage. So that's how I set up my CPU monitoring. Here you can view CPU history graph, last hour, day, week or month. The list here shows your processes order by most demanding on top. You can monitor up to 15 processes at once. If you select 5, it will show you 5 most demanding processes. I like to see the maximum 15 processes. Here you can change the format of CPU usage. For example, on 6-core machine with total 12 threads, it goes up to 1200%. You can change it to be displayed traditionally from 0 to 100%. So, right next to CPU, I like to have the memory component. So, again from scratch, I want to have the name of the component and I want also see used versus free overview. So, when you click on it, you can see again which applications in your system eat most of your memory, sorted from top to bottom. Again, you can set how many of those applications to see in the overview. Then I want to see my network activity. So, as you can see, I like to have these icons in the top bar, so I can at any time have real-time information about utilizing my network. You can also change the colors for upload and download. You have bunch of options how to customize this component, so set it like you want. And on the bottom you have again overview which applications are accessing your network. Real-time speed of reads of upload versus download. Next to it I want to have my disks activity component. I have only one disk in this system, but you can see here also all network shares connected. So I can see immediately, just by looking to the top menu bar, actual read and write speeds of my disk. I can see used free space on my disk, again also graph format, and you can see even SSD lifetime here. If you want in the top bar more disks, just simply drag their name from available disks to show in menu bar. And the last component I have activated on all my macOS computers are the sensors. Normally at default you will see it like this. So I always customize it to see all my cores separately. So I drag each core sensor to the top menu bar. You can display it as a big icon. So I drag CPU core 2, CPU core 3, and so on. And I want to see also the GPU die temperature on top. So now I see temperatures of all cores and GPU. On multi-core systems it's quite long, so you can choose the second view, which will display them in more compact way. Here you can see temperature graphs of each of your CPU cores and other sensors in your system. Motherboard fans, CPU frequency, and so on. In the global section you can customize the overall look of iStat menus. You can choose color of those tiny graphs, so if I will select for example yellow one, they will become yellow. I like my purple. You can also choose the drop-down theme, here to white, light gray, dark gray, or blurred background. I like this one. Very important here is the update frequency. I like it to set to fast because I'm obsessed with monitoring of everything. So it means the refresh rate of all sensors will be fast. But again, you can set it as you want. If you have a notebook, you can choose some useful information about your battery. You can display time in several locations. You can also combine some components together. I personally don't like this option. I prefer the way I showed you already. So I will again activate each component in the exact order in which I want them to be displayed in the top menu bar. iStat menus are running at default in 14 days trial mode, but here from menu you can easily buy it or register. But I advise, wait with it until my next video, I have some surprise for you. Current latest version of iStat menus is compatible with macOS 10.11 El Capitan up to macOS 10.14 Mojave, but on their page you can still download even older versions for much older macOS 10 versions. So, if you want to have also absolute control over what is going on in your Macintosh or Hackintosh, then my recommendation is quite clear. Go for iStat menus. For just 15 bucks, it's a steal. And as I said, wait for a surprise in my next video. So, I hope you found in my today's video some new inspiration. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. You can also join my Macintosh and Hackintosh groups on Facebook, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Macintosh and Hackintosh friends!